How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior, to thee. Great, how great thou art. When Joy shall feel, then I shall be in humble adoration, and then I God great thou art.
For a reminder, you have a love has used you and will continue to use you. Amen. As you live for the Lord Jesus Christ, sing songs like that for the Lord Jesus. I'm so happy to see you this morning. It's just good to be in the Lord's house with the people. Amen. And to preach this morning, I want to bring up on it is called, and call up there. Maybe somebody would out temporarily, and we're going to introduce this song to you. He's going to help us with it, and we want to know what is. Okay. Up there. Hey, Easter. What is that? Cliff Rogers. I don't know how to say it. Year and seasons pass. Crazy dreams. What Easter. Years for next slide there. Even when Christ. The tomb, a roll should have been rolled. Suffered for two thieves who hung beside him on the tree. Is for his everlasting. R is to you and me. Easter came to God above. We learned that from Charlie. I tried to get the notes, sing it this morning. To set the stage for East. I'm not going to say. What Easter is really all. When I was a kid, the egg hunt. Do that if you practice that, that's all right. What to do. But Easter is the early dawn. Rose from the tomb, that tomb. A is for the angel, the stone away. Is for lasting love, righteousness he gives to you and me. Came out above. Here, let's keep focused on what God says. And we will have early sunrise worship on Easter morning and breakfast for those who can come. And so you are invited to come. Now let's turn to the Word of God this morning. And in your Bible, you know where we read from. You may turn there because we will pick it up and begin the preaching of the Word of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am so thrilled this morning that God saved me. He saved me. See, this is not just religion. This is a relationship with the God who has created us, who has revealed himself as the Lord Jesus Christ. He is my Savior and he is my Lord. And I'm a new creation in Jesus Christ. I'm born again. I'm saved. And therefore, this morning, I just want to talk about living in God's family as a redeemed person. This is something that is very, very vital in these days. And I'm going to pick it up beginning at verse 15. We're all searching for something, trying to find satisfaction. Many think they can find it in money, others in sex, others in pleasure. Others are looking for it in drugs and alcohol. But I want to tell you something. There's something that God has promised to you this morning, and it's found in the Lord Jesus Christ. It is that peace that he talks about in his word. And I'm going to focus on that this morning. There is something else that God has done for us. And he says, number one, I want you to let the word of Christ dwell in you. Dwell in you how? Richly. How does the word dwell when it dwells richly? It means that it's fully. It is appreciated. You love it. You meditate upon it. You study it. You memorize it, all of those things. When the Word of God is fully being manifested in your life, when it's dwelling in you richly, you're a well-rounded person. The needs that you have, God will meet as you live for the glory of the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, I'm going to tell you a little bit more. The Word of God will make you wise. The Word of God will teach you something about how to live and how to relate to others. The Word of God will counsel you. We all need a counselor, and his name is Jesus Christ. The Word of God will counsel you in whatever area of life that you're facing. The Word of God will put music in your life. It will make you sing. Even when you're going through a time, council today. And may your name be honored in what we do. Thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. See, when the Bible says, let the peace of God rule in your heart, it's not giving you a suggestion. It's not just saying to you, do this if you want to do it. If you don't want to do it, it really doesn't matter. This is an imperative command. And it is what they call a present tense command. In other words, it's something that is to become a habit in your life. It is a habitual practice in your life. Let the peace of God serve in your life as the barometer, God's peace. Now you say, what is this peace? It means to be whole. It means the lack of, it means the opposite of war and fights and conflicts. And we have them going on in our world today. Killing their parents. Like cats and dogs. Well, this man said, I just was sorry that But God has called, He has extended a call. You've given him too much already. But God is God. You see, I couldn't serve as his administrator. No. No, out of here because I look at how. Grateful to his peace. You were called when he extended that call to you. And he says, now be thankful. Look at the second implication here. He says, let the word of God dwell in you richly. I want to focus on that word richly. And here again, let the word of God is another command. This is not a suggestion. You do this if you feel like doing it. This is a command from God. Allow God's word to permeate your life, to saturate your soul. And if you're going to allow that to happen, there are a lot of things that we all need to do that the Bible tells us we should be doing. I'll just remind you of some of them here this morning. So let the word of God shine richly in your heart. Accept the word of God, and that's what we are told here in verse 16. Let it dwell in you richly. What does it mean to let the word dwell richly? Well, just let me suggest some things to you here, and there are many other things that you could put in that place. We ought to read the word of God. It ought to be by our table, and we ought to keep it, amen, on us at some point. Amen? It's the Bible. Men have died. They suffered in order to get the scriptures to us. And it's written by God to us for our admonition today. Read it. There are not one book. Now, I don't come to anybody's house to check out your library. I go to a preacher's office. Not one book. And usually those are the kinds that jump on those who love to study and to read and to see what God has to say. Not one book on the shelf that will help you. Not even the Bible. Yeah. Come to church, got to get the Bible from the back of the pew. Well, we are coming to the place where we will have a Bible in the back of the pew. And if you don't have a Bible at home, take the Bible from the back of the pew, but read it. Don't just take it. Amen. Put it in the back of your car. Take the Bible from the back of the pew if you don't have one. God has given us this book. It is inspired by God, given to us by men of God who were moved by the Holy Ghost. That's what it's used in 2 Peter 1:21. It was just as if the wind took a leaf and blew it. That's how God gave us the Holy Scriptures. And men wrote the very voice of God. And we have it today in 66 books called the Old Testament and 27 books called the New Testament. Amen. Old and New Testament, 66 books, rather. And we take it so lightly. And I think of people who could not read, and many who do read today, they read the Bible. Open the Bible and begin to read from the book, the Word of God. And how sad it is today that we cannot read in our public school system, "Thou shalt not kill," because there's a prejudiced attitude towards the scriptures. Now we got Columbines everywhere, taking weapons and shooting people for no reason whatsoever. Because our children have not been brought up in a system that says, "Thou shalt not kill. Honor the Lord, love your neighbor, help your neighbor, but listen, don't leave your door open. Leave your door open with your alarm off if you want to." That's where we are. We're in a very tough situation now. And so read the Word of God. I'm not boasting or bragging, but when my children were young, I was in seminary, and I loved to study. Perhaps I don't love to read as much as I should. I feel sorry about that, but I'm praying God's going to give me an opportunity to take off from here Amen. One day a week, and head to the library, because that's where I do my best service. But I would take my son on my lap and one book in my hand, whether it's Greek or whether it's Hebrew, some Old Testament. Or there, or his daddy reading.